shit, white, watch Manny back down.
Let's see.
Yeah, there's a lot of them that, when you go way back, like my third round knockout with Gabriel Royales, it was like LA rivalry, you know, and so there's, I just look up all the fights there. They were pretty cool. All the highlights, whatever.
So if you prepare for a fight like this against an MMA fighter who doesn't have the same striking ability that you have in your career, what of your past fights do you look at that you think will get you hype and get you up for this matchup?
You know, I mean, I think a fight that I'm going to watch a lot is Bernard Hopkins, even though he stopped me with a body shot. I felt I was winning the fight, and even Bernard would say that I was right there. He's a huge guy, Bernard. So it's a fight that I'm gonna watch carefully again and study. But what I really have to study is I have to go back to and watch. And we have started watching Belfort's fights, and because the punches come from different angles. So I have to get used to that as well. Like, yeah, he has his homework to do, and my punches come from different angles as well. But his punches, like, everything's a challenge. I mean, from top to bottom, Belfort's a challenge to me, you know, mentally and physically and stylistically, you know. So that's something that I'm gonna have to figure out, you know.
Talk to us about, obviously, Mexican fighters fighting a few days before Mexican independence, always very important. Yeah. However, you're also fighting on 9/11.
Right.
You won, you know, obviously, gold medal for the U.S. Yeah. So, basically representing both, what does that mean to you, especially here in Los Angeles?
Yeah, no, I've always been proud I've always been proud of my roots, you know. And it's funny because it's like, all my life, I've always felt like, okay, I'm not from there, but I'm not from here, like, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, I have a gold medal. I'm U.S. I've always been very proud, you know? But, you know, proud of my roots, basically it. So that's the reason why we've always fought on that weekend. It's a big weekend. But I think you brought it up, somebody brought it up where it's 9/11, like, oh, snap. Wow, that's even... It stands for something huge, you know. It's, I don't know what it is. It's like stars or aligned or whatever. It's like, but 9/11 and the whole Mexican weekend. It's like, yeah, it's gonna be a special night.
You said you got.
You changed this fight from an exhibition to a real sanctioned fight. Yeah. What does this say about not only you but Belfort as well?
Well, I mean, you know, I was thinking about the exhibitions that we've seen, you know, just doesn't do it for me, you know. If I'm gonna get in the ring and sacrifice my life, let's go all in, you know. And look, I have nothing against Belfort. I will never have anything against, you know, his legacy. And I do have one thing to tell him, is that we're gonna fucking beat the shit out of each other, you know. He's gonna get some punches in, yeah. They're gonna hurt. Maybe the next day and the following day. I mean, but it's gonna be fun. This is what I miss, you know. Like I'm getting myself into this. I'm the one that loves this. I love this. So yeah, let's go.
Oscar, estaban hace poquito al respecto. ¿Por qué regresar al boxeo? Habla un poquito al respecto de tu oponente.
Primeramente por la pasión, por el amor. Extraño mucho el deporte, es la razón. Yo creo que el hecho que me está dando motivación, el boxeo es mi vida, es todo, es mi todo. El boxeo me da la motivación para seguir viviendo, para seguir con el sacrificio de ser buena persona, de ser buen padre, de lo que sea. El boxeo me da todo, es mi aire que respiro. Digo, suena ridículo, pero es la verdad.
¿Has pensado en la familia, en los hijos, para esta pelea? Es un poquito peligroso, ¿no? 47 años,
cara. No, 48. Pero sí, es peligroso, sí, es difícil, sí. No es una decisión fácil, pero la verdad que me siento como 20. Y he estado entrenando inteligentemente, con muchas ganas, pero la razón, la diferencia es que lo estoy haciendo por mí mismo, es todo. Obviamente por mis hijos, pero por mí mismo. Quiero yo hacer algo por mí mismo, porque yo siempre peleé por el mundo. Yo siempre he estado peleando para la gloria de la gente, del público, de esto, de esto. No, ahora yo estoy peleando por mí mismo, para hacerme yo contento.
Para sentir esa adrenalina, esos, los golpes, te hace falta.
Me hace falta que me peguen.
Fight,
sí.
TV, fight TV.
Do you think you can be a world champion again? Do you think you can go the route of Bernard and replicate something like that?
I believe so. Yeah. I believe so. I think that with this mentality, with this mental strength that I have now, that is, with training smarter, with my motivation, just in life in general, it's a different route that I'm taking. It's like it's been literally Groundhog Day for me for many years, man, doing the same shit. And now it's like I'm taking a different route, and this route here, it's much easier. It's strenuous. It's hard. It's difficult for your body. It's tough at 48, but that different route, it's like it's much easier. It's like, shit, why didn't I figure it out a long time ago? So the fact that George Foreman has done it, the fact that Bernard Hopkins has done it, like, hey, maybe it's my time.
Right, last question with Fight TV.
Manny Pacquiao's 42. You're taking on a big challenge at 48, obviously, a former UFC champion, a former legend, I want to say the youngest heavyweight champion in UFC history. What do you tell, Manny Pacquiao at 42? Do you understand him as being a fighter and kind of just still wanting the biggest challenges that are out there?
Yeah, I mean, here you have Manny Pacquiao that's possibly going to run for president, but yet still he misses getting in the ring. He loves boxing. He loves what he does. He loves what brought him, the glory. Of course I understand. Of course he understands me. Of course, we do it because we love it. That's the bottom line.
Do you see him winning that fight?
I see it being a great fight, actually. Spence is a dangerous fighter who can figure you out. And not just because I went up against Pacquiao and he did what he did to me, but the footwork might be the difference in this fight. The footwork, meaning like he moves side to side, and when you see Manny Pacquiao with those big fucking calves, he's a dangerous fella, let me tell you.
All right, thank you. Last question, Fight TV, and then we gotta go.
Oscar, déjame decir, para Fight TV, por favor. Un enorme pay-per-view que va a poder ver la raza y que desde ya quiero que los invites a que lo compren, porque es la pelea de tu vida, es una pelea para ti que te la dedicas tú solo.
Sí, no, es una pelea fuerte, difícil, un reto.
Claro.
Y nada, un mensaje también, un mensaje para todos que no importa qué estás viviendo, la edad, lo que sea, si dedicas tu vida, si dedicas tu esfuerzo, tu mentalidad hacia un reto difícil, un reto fuerte, no
significa que no, claro, todo es posible. Una vez campeón, siempre campeón, una vez guerrero, siempre guerrero.
Así es, así es, y la verdad que extraño mucho, demasiado, el deporte, y no sé, que me llamen loco, lo que sea, pero extraño, extraño.
So, there you have it, another great video for ES News. EsNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach, and you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.